Hello, statisticians. I'm really proud of the job you did with probability distributions. You got the activities done very quickly and very efficiently, and so we're moving on ahead using those probability distributions to find the mean, variance, standard deviation, and what's known as the expected value for a discrete random variable. So if we get started here, mean, variance, and standard deviation of a probability distribution. To find the mean, you take the sum of each possibility times its corresponding probability. To find the variance, this is the shortcut thing. You take the square of each possibility times its probability, you add those up, and then you subtract the mean, which you found here. And the third formula is standard deviation, where you just take the square root of the variance. Now, variance and standard deviation, what that helps us to determine is how spread out our data is and how variable our data. Are there a lot of extremes with our data? Last, the new term is expected value. But if you notice, this looks just like this. The expected value of a probability distribution is just the mean. It's the theoretical mean. So that's all that is. Now you have your formulas written down at the top of your notes. Just to remind you, the round-off rule for the mean, the variance, the standard deviation, and the variance are that you round one more decimal place than the number of decimal places in your variable x. If the values of x are integers, you round to one decimal place. You also reduce fractions to their lowest terms. Alrighty, so let's do an example. Find the mean number of spots that appear when a die is tossed. If you remember, you take the probability times the data value x. So if this is the number of spots on your dice, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the number of spots. And here's a nice little rolly dice down there. The probability of each one of these occurring is 1/6, so it's the same for all of those. To find out, now your book doesn't do this, but I thought it would be convenient to put an extra row right under your table. Since you know you're going to be finding the mean, I'm going to take this x, 1, times the probability associated with this x value and multiply them. So 1 times 1/6 is 1/6, 2 times 1/6 is 2/6, 3 times 1/6 is 3/6, and so on. So I just multiplied all those because to find the mean, all we have to do is add them up. So hence the mean is going to be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 over 6, which is 21 over 6 or 3.5. Bada boom, bada bing, you're done. Pretty easy. So, drawing a tree diagram to find the mean number of children who will be girls. If you remember a tree diagram, when you have a baby, it can be a boy or a girl. So then from there, if they have another baby, if they have a boy first, they could have a boy or a girl. If you have a girls first, it could be a boy or a girl. And then here would be your sample space. Boy, 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 girl, girl, boy, girl. So we're going to do a probability distribution and then find the mean. Number of girls. There's 0 girls, 1 girl, and 2 girls in our sample space. So probability of no girls would be just the first one, both boys, which is 1/4. 1 girl is 2/4, and 2 girls is 1/4. Then to find the mean, we know we're going to have to multiply our random variable x times the probability associated with it. So 0 times a fourth is 0. 1 times 2/4 is 2/4, or 1/2. 2 times 1/4 is 1/2 as well. If we add those up, the mean is going to be 1. You add them up, 0 plus a half plus a half, you get 1. That's the expected girl. Kind of figure that out. Now, 3 coins tossed in a fountain. Find the mean number of heads that occur. So when we did this one in example 5-1, we had all the possibilities listed there, and the probabilities were as follows: 1/8, 3/8, 3/8, and 1/8. You can bring out your old notes and check that out, but I ain't lying to you, that's what it was. To find the mean, you multiply the 0 times the 1/8, the 1 times the 3/8, and so on. So this is going to be 0, and then we're going to add 3/8, and we're going to add 6/8, and 3 times 1/8, we'll add another 3/8. 3 plus 6 plus 3, that's 12 over 8, which is 1.5. Even though the mean value of 1.5 cannot occur as an outcome, nevertheless, it is the long run or theoretical average, or 1.5 heads, units, they're whole numbers. It's still considered our theoretical average, hence the word theory. Okay, next example, 5/8. Probability distribution shown represents the number of trips 5 nights or more American adults take per year. So you've got 6%, 70%, 20%, 3%, 1%. To find the mean, you just multiply random variable x times its probability. You'll get those values. And the mean, you just add them all together, and you end up with the mean, which is 1.23. Hence, the mean number of trips lasting 5 nights or more per year taken by American adults is 1.23. Now, if we're French, we'd take a lot more than that, but we're not French. 5-9, here's where we're using our next formulas. You might want to look at the front just to familiarize what your formula is for variance and standard deviation. Once you find variance, all you have to do is take the square root. So we also are going to have to subtract the mean off the end. So we're going to square each outcome by corresponding probability, sum those products, and then subtract the square of the mean. This should look familiar to you if you remember your frequency distribution way back last year. So variance is going to equal, we're going to take all our possible outcomes. Now this was example 5/5, which is the number of dots on the die. So we know we're going to square each possibility, 1 squared, 2 squared, da da da, and then we're going to multiply it times the probability for each one of those. So here's what we're going to be adding together, 1/2 squared times 1/6, and so on. And then at the end, this was our mean, our theoretical mean, that we're going to subtract off the end. If you crunch those numbers in your handy dandy rusty dusty, you end up with 2.9. That's the variance. Standard deviation is going to be the square root of 2.9, or approximately 1.7. Now 5/10, I want you to try on your own to see if you can use those formulas appropriately. So I want you to see if you can find the mean and the standard deviation, and so on. So 5/10, I want you to see if you can find the mean first, and then the standard deviations, and so on. And I will do part 2 notes tomorrow. Bye.